Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you about gastrointestinal duplication cyst in the imaging. GI duplication cysts have three defining characteristics. One, well-developed coat of smooth muscle. Second, epithelial lining representing some parts of GI tract. Third, attachment to GI tract, rarely isolated cysts with no persistent attachment. Most common signs and symptoms: pain, palpable mass, rectal bleeding, interception of valves causing small bowel obstruction, most represent for ileal duplication, may be incidental finding. Other symptoms: ulceration, perforation, hemorrhage, vascular compromise, and urinary retention have been reported from mass effect. Respiratory symptoms in thoracic and oral cavity lesion may be detected on prenatal sonography. Demographic age: congenital lesion most often representing less than 2 years of age, up to 85%, and up to 30% present in adulthood. Epidemiology: prevalent of 1 per 4,500 fetal neonatal autopsy. Top differential analysis: mesenteric lung cortic malformation, ovarian cyst, meconial pseudocyst, oracosis, hydrometrocorpus, cholecystitis, aneurysm. In imaging, cystic, around 80 to 90% with 10 to 20% lesion with well-defined wall. Can occur in the volume, more than 30%, and esophagus, 18 to 20%. Teachers, but not hearing with adjacent GI tract. Ultrasound is best modality to visualize key feature, though finding with highest specificity have lowest sensitivity. Gut signature sign: three laminar apparent of wall is less specific than 5-layer wall. Y sign: hypoechoic muscularis, appropriate device at points of attachment between cyst and adjacent bowel. Peristasis of cyst wall is pathognomonic if visualized. All the sounds of the upper abdomen in a 15 months old with intermittent pain and vomiting. So, an ileocolic interception extending to the transverse colon and terminating in a complex cystic mass with a 3-laminar wall. The mass was initially mistaken for fluid traps around the interception. Radiograph in the same patient after successful air enema reduction confirmed by free reflux of air into a small bowel. So, persistent valvulus outlined by air in the mid-right abdomen concern for a lead point. SSFSE G2 of air in a 1-week-old with a prenatally detected animal is, so 3.5 cm cystic mass inferior to the liver and immediately lateral to the dilated common bile duct. A duodenal duplication cyst compressing the common bile duct was confirmed at surgery. Ultrasounds in a 1-month-old show a well circumscribed rosacea of the right upper quadrant with a 3-laminar gut signature wall, confirmed to be an enteric duplication cyst at surgery. White layer can be seen in points of wall. Contrasting NCT, so a large biopsy cystic lesion in the upper abdomen with well-defined wall. The cystic lesion was resected and found to be a gastric duplication cyst. Treatment: complete surgical resection is ideal. Partial excision with removal of lining or marsupialization may be required in difficult regions. Thank you.